June 9, 2001. Gary and I were skating at a hospital on top of a huge hill overlooking a valley. An ambulance came in and took out a dead woman. Gary asked me why she wasn't moving or blinking. They hadn't closed her eyes yet. She must have died on the way. A car full of family and friends came in with the ambulance. They were all crying and hugging each other. One woman screamed hysterically and grabbed at the woman's body, asking her to wake up. I had to tell Gary that her soul went to heaven. I didn't believe a word of it, but I knew it would be easier for him to understand. 2 days from now, at 9 a.m., planes will hit the World Trade Center, killing over 3,000 people. I'll tell Gary that there is no God, and all of this is meaningless. But today, there is a God, and he has a plan for him. He doesn't know it, but a year from now, our family will be torn apart, and I will move far away and won't see or talk to him for 5 years. And as we sit on the hood of our car, the sun goes down, and he asks me what I want out of my life. I tell him I don't know. Tell him about the dream I had the night before, where I'm riding in a car full of strangers and singing to some song I've never heard and smoking a cigarette, and we swerve off the road and hit a tree. I go through the windshield and hit the edge of a fence, dislocating my jaw and flipping me into a wall where my neck is broken and my skull is fractured. I bleed to death in excruciating pain. I will have this dream periodically until I meet all of the strangers one by one, introducing them all to each other until we are a close group of friends. I will set these events in motion, and I will die. But today, in the warm light of the sunset, I don't see it. I just see the sunset. I smile back and shake my head. I have absolutely no idea. I am afraid.
creation will be the end of me. Blurring the lines between what I want and what I need. Calm down, don't let her see how fast your heart is beating. Calm down, control your breathing. And if you don't want me, well, it's just tough luck. I think about you, but I know I'm not good enough. And I've built you up too much. No, I can't say what's on my mind in case I go and scare you away. Calm down, don't let her see how fast your heart. Calm down, control your breathing. All the people have thoughts optimistic and sweet. And how can I compete with the world at your feet? Would it be cruel, be cruel, be cruel to let my eyes return to you? Stupid thoughts. I wanna fight my own advice, for I will only feel remorse. I just want you in my life.
Long days piled in before you'd speak, as the storm crawled to meet the shoreline. And it began to rain at once. I tried to keep the awful things at bay from I'm Reaches the heart, we all fall out.
When I push you bites her lips and turns away. From that point on, she's not just another face. She turns back to him with those hazel eyes. There's no point in return, she's all that's on his mind. But he doesn't know what she's been through before. Puts herself on the front lines with no reward and takes care of everyone else before herself. She's on his mind and I think he takes her for granted, but to her surprise he needs her more than she needs him. Oh, won't fight, no, just walks away, won't tell his secrets, just keeps them safe. That's why she's not just another. Talks about to his friends, he acts like it's nothing, but we all know the truth. But she thinks she's been through it all before, but this time it's different and she can't ignore those signs that he's sending, cause they're nothing but rude. He's singing, hold my hand, oh, hold it tight, whether the weather is cold.
Yeah. I need this. What I said about Hannah Breeze. Let me see my superimposition of a face on a poster on its way. Arriving any day, it will accompany me every night. Welcoming a press cast onto the drywall surrounding me will probably return me to this face.